I go to see a trailer that I'm interested in, one of the first things I do is look at the interior for water damage. And the common places for water damage, which is of course caused by leaks or by vents and windows that are left open in weather, are the vent and the windows, also the door. So any openings in the trailer have a potential to leak. If people would change the putty tape that everything is installed with on a 10 to 15 year basis and not leave the windows, doors, and vents open while it's raining, there would be no problem. The wood would be fine. And as you've seen in my previous videos, this damage is very difficult to repair because you have to take the whole trailer apart, just like I'm doing with the DeVille, which is what I'm standing in now. Another place you want to look for damage is the floor. If you want to look for water damage, and if you see places where it has puddled, for instance there, then you want to step on it and see if it's solid or not. This is solid. None of the floor in here has been damaged to the point where it has to be replaced. Around the door is another place. It's a little soft here, but not too bad. Not too bad at all. Under the vent, of course, where I just showed you. And then the windows. They always tend to leak at the bottom of the windows, just like here. All this paneling will have to be replaced. Again, it's not easy to do. Most trailers, it cannot be done from the inside. What you can do from the inside is overlay new paneling over the old paneling. But that's a cheapo way to do it, and a lazy man's way to do it. As you can see here, this window didn't get much leaking. I will be able to repair this wood with just a little sanding and re-varnishing. Re-shellacking, actually. So basically, those are the things you want to look for. Now the door, if left open, that is also a birch panel that will have to be replaced because it's been left open and the sun and the water got to it and ruined it. So I will replace that panel by dismantling the door. There are a couple of different types of windows in these trailers. This is a lever activated window made by Heir, H-E-I-R. They were the windows that were used from the get-go in the 40s all the way up to the 60s. In the 60s, just as this trailer, they started combining the Heir windows with the louvered windows, which operate by cranks. Now the Heir windows, there's not much to look for. It either works or it doesn't. You want to check the screens out also. This is the way they work with a lever. As you can see, I'm trying to get the light right in here. I don't know what's the matter with this camera. Need a new camera, I'm poor. So you want to make sure that they work. You also want to look for water damage to see if the seals have been damaged. For the louvered windows, of course, you want to try the crank. And check them both ways. Sometimes they work one way and not the other. They may open and then not close. This one works both ways. Lucky for me, all the windows work in here. I'm going to have to replace that window because they put an air conditioner in it. I'll replace it with probably a louvered window. They're the easiest to find. In the back, I have another Heir window. Activates with the crank. There you go. And as you can see, the screen is screwed up, so I'll have to replace that. And off to the side, yet another crank type louvered window. It opens and it closes. You also want to see if the vent works. This one does not. So I will have to either replace the part that's broken which some parts can be replaced, or I will have to replace the vent. The screen is good and can be cleaned. You always want to replace all the gaskets on all the windows and all the openings, vents, and all the putty tape on the outside, because in most cases the putty tape has dried over the years, gotten hard, brittle, and is starting to come apart. So you will have leaking happen in the future. If the thing has a toilet, like this one does, it will have anyway, I haven't really installed it yet, it's just sitting there. But if it has a toilet or any other fixtures, faucets, whatever, you want to see if they work. A lot of them have hand pumps. Check to see if they work by putting some water in the tank and check the hand pump. You also want to check to see if you have a breaker or a fuse box of some sort. This one has a breaker box. I believe this was installed at a later date. I'm not sure, but kind of looks that way. Might be original. But there it is. Sometimes they have screw-in fuses on the older ones. And what you want to do is plug the trailer in and see if all that works.